Hi, today I'm going to talk about the things that I will be doing in the next movies for my channel, and I will be solving or at least replicating the exercise in this book on robot training manual metric version. So let's take a look at the exercises. The first one is the study of a reinforced concrete two-dimensional frame, shown here. Exercise number two, we'll have to cover all these steps here. Exercise number two will be on a steel frame, also a two-dimensional frame, but this time made of steel, shown here. Exercise number three will be on a special analysis, elastoplastic analysis on robot structural analysis in this two-dimensional frame. Then we will we will do an exercise on moving loads, also on a two-dimensional frame. This one is a frame. The exercise number five will also be on moving loads, but this time on a three-dimensional frame, which is much more cooler than a two-dimensional frame. Exercise number six will be on, three-dimensional steel structure with steel connections. Then exercise number seven will be also on a 3D steel structure, but this time with masses. Exercise number eight will be a bit different, will be the definition and the analysis of a concrete floor. I have here a picture of the floor. The floor, here it is. This floor will have this opening, this support, this side will also be supported, and this side will also be supported. Exercise number nine will be the study of this three-dimensional solid structure that looks like a table with six legs. Okay. Exercise number 10 will be a series of geometrical definition of shell structures. The first one, here they are. The first one is this silo. The second one will be this chimney cooler, shown here. The third one, I guess it is a pipeline, yes. Here it is, study of a pipeline. This pipeline here. Last one on shell structure will be the study of axisymmetric structure, shown here. Very cool. Very cool structure. Exercise number 11, which is the best one, I guess. It is a very complete exercise, is the study of a three-dimensional single-span road bridge with a moving load we will have a concrete floor, and we will have these elements over here made of steel. Exercise number 12, which is the last one, but also very important, is a definition of a thin walled section, solid thin walled section. I'll try to make all the steps shown here in all exercises, or at least the most important ones. Oh, I hope you guys enjoy. I hope you guys subscribe, and thank you very much.